Hi everybody, it's Jess. I am here just with a quick card share today. I have a piece of Desert Storm environmental cardstock from Nina, and I'm scoring it just to a standard A2 size card there. And I wanted to try out this new stamp set from Hero Arts. It's their Wish Big Cling stamp set, and it was just in their new release, and it has these really fun candles and then the large scale Wish Big and Happy Birthday sentiment. So I tried to use my stamp press there, but with this Big Mama archival pad, it was kind of tricky to ink up. So I switched to a really big block, and I'm just inking it up with the archival ink there, and I'm going to stamp it so it looks as though they are extending on either side of the card here. So you'll see what I mean in a minute. I've tried to stamp it as close to the center as I could, and then I'm taking one end, just inking up a portion of it, and then stamping it next to that side. And then I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. The reason I decided to use archival ink, I don't often use it, but it is nice for using with these INKTENSE pencils. It is a waterproof ink, so it will not smear, it will not streak, it will not bleed. It is perfect to use with water. So there are a couple of ways I like to apply these pencils, and there is sort of a learning curve with these. The more you play with them, the better you get. So my favorite way probably to use them is to go ahead and take it off of the tip of them, and I just touch my wet brush to the tip of the pencil and then just go ahead and dab it on there. Another way I like to do it is to just color right in the candle and then take my wet brush and just apply a little water and start moving that pigment around. These are kind of tricky when you start with them. You just have to sort of get a feel for how the ink moves and how the pigment distributes, how much water you need to use, what different paper type you need to use. But once you get the hang of them, they're really fun to play with. So I try to speed up coloring the rest of the candles and make it pretty quick for you guys. So here you go. Okay, I have all my candles colored in here, and I wanted to take the Happy Birthday sentiment that is also in the set, and I just love these sentiments. They're super large scale, which is nice. There's not a ton of sets that have this large of sentiments. So I started originally inking that up with Memento, but I changed my mind because I wanted to do some coloring on the sentiment as well. This is probably the most rainbow bright card I've ever made, but it's for a kid's birthday, and I like it. I think it's fun and bright and happy. So I wanted to sort of add the rainbow to the happy birthday as well. So I'm just going in to certain letters and then just doing the rainbow colors. So red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple, indigo. And then I will just touch those with the tip of my water brush and get the color moving around on those and add just a nice little watercolor look to the sentiment. And I didn't mention this earlier when I was talking about these INKTENSE pencils, but that's a water brush. You can fill the barrel with water and it will come down the tip. But I actually find that with these pencils, that's too much water. So I need to just empty out the barrel and then just dip it into a cup of water. And I've had a lot more success doing it that way. So I'm just cutting a little banner edge onto my sentiment strip there. And I'm setting that aside because I need to add some yellow stickles to my candle wicks. And I had to get that going off to the side there. These work a lot better if you store them upside down. I'm currently not doing that, and I can notice a difference that it is a little bit harder to get them going. All right, now I'm just going to mount the sentiment strip on some foam dimensionals and just slap it right in the center of all those candles as close as I can get there. And just to pop it up a little bit. And I think the last thing I do here is round the bottom two corners with the 1/4 inch corner chomper, and that's the card. So thanks so much for watching, you guys. You can always check out my blog, JessLarsonDesign.com, for more.